as I mentioned in my previous charity shop haul, I will be DIYing this dress that I found. And this is finally the video for that. So if you saw that video, you will know that it fits quite nicely around the top here, but then the rest of it is really big. And then like the bottom of the skirt here is not enough room for me anyway. So I'm going to do some altering and make it something that I would like to wear more. I think I'm just going to leave the straps as they are. And it's also got a lace-up bit at the back here, which I will just be leaving alone. So the changes I'll be making are, first of all, I'm going to open up the side seams up to a certain point. I haven't decided precisely where just yet. And then once I've opened those side seams up, I'm going to add in a panel of this stretchy mesh. And I chose this because it flows really nicely and I like mesh detailing. So I'll be doing the skirt part first, and from there I'll be taking it in around the bodice area. I'll just be tucking it in and sewing it down, nothing too fancy. And I think I'll probably leave it there. I'll see if I want to add any more details later on once I've got those things done. It shouldn't take too long to do everything, but knowing me, it's going to take much longer than it should. I would of course do a try on at the end to show you how it's turned out. It may take me more than today to finish this, so if you see me wearing something different, then that will be why. I'll just show you what it looks like on as is now, in case you didn't see that other haul video. For this I'm using my Swiss Army knife, which has got an attachment of a pair of scissors, which is quite small, so it is good for using on seams. I prefer using it over a stitch ripper because it's much more accurate and I don't have to worry about ripping the fabric by accident. Most seams have two lines of straight stitching, which here I have pulled out, and then I'm just able to open it up very easily. Next, I'm measuring my mesh out to make sure that I have a square, which I can then fold in half in triangle shape and cut down the middle. Cutting mesh in a straight line is very difficult because of how stretchy the fabric is and how much it moves around, so I just choose a line of holes to follow and then just cut those down the middle. It takes a long time and it's very fiddly, but I found that it works very well. When it came to cutting the mesh square in half, I just folded it and followed the crease freehand with the scissors. To sew the mesh panels in, I used a stitch that would prevent the satin from fraying. The most time-consuming bit about this part was making sure that both fabrics were lying flat and making sure that the mesh wasn't stretched when I was sewing it on.
And here we have the side panels in. As you can see, it goes up quite far, so this will be a special occasions outfit, unless I just put another skirt underneath, of course, but yeah. So now I'm going to work out what I want to do around the middle here. So I think I'm going to bring it in like this at the front and then sew here and here. And I might put a bit of lacing in the front as well. I haven't decided yet. But that will be that for the front. And then the back, as you can see, because it's elasticated, that's given me a lot of problems. So I'm going to take the elastic off and then bring this open bit down further, so I'll cut into the fabric here, which will then bring it in at the back, so that'll take care of that problem. So yeah, that's the plan. And, I will come back when the dress is complete.
As predicted, this took several more days to complete, hence the outfit change here. When dismantling clothes a bit like this, you do tend to end up with lots of thread, maybe scraps of fabric that you won't be able to use necessarily. So I always save those bits and put them in a container so I can use them to make a pillow or something out of later so they don't go to waste. Here I was deciding how much of the fabric I was going to cut, and I decided not to actually remove any of the fabric as I realised that that wouldn't really work. So I ended up folding all of the fabric in and sewing it together. I'm using a fabric pencil to mark the places where I'm going to sew it. At this point I made sure to try the dress on again just to be sure that it would be the right fit. This part needed to be hand-sewn, as it wasn't possible to use the machine for this. I then did a quick edge stitch to create a new lace-up part at the back. This came out much neater than I had expected it to, which was a very nice surprise. To replace the elastic loops at the back, I cut some small pieces of mesh fabric and sewed those down. To finish the dress off, I hand-stitched a couple of mesh strips on the front of the dress.
Stuck from the